Hello students, today we are going to see next theorem, that is maximum power transfer theorem with AC supply. So already we have seen the maximum power transfer theorem in the first unit. So what is the use of maximum power transfer theorem? What it states? To transfer a maximum power, the load resistance should be equal to RTH. That we have seen in the first unit, that is the RL should be equal to RTH, Thevenin's resistance. Here we are going to see for AC supply. So what is the statement? To transfer maximum average power, here we have to consider maximum average power, not instantaneous power. Here we have to consider average power. Why we have to consider average power? Because while discussing average power and instantaneous power, the instantaneous power depends on time and average power is independent of time. That's why we are considering average power. Maximum average power, to transfer maximum average power to the load impedance must be equal to the load impedance must be equal to the complex conjugate of Thevenin's impedance. It means that if you want to transfer the maximum power to the load, how you have to adjust the load impedance in such a way that should be equal to the complex conjugate of Thevenin's impedance. So according to this statement, here I can write it is that let us consider ZL is equal to, let us consider in maximum power transfer theorem we have to consider three cases. So we'll see K one by one. So let us consider ZL is equal to load impedance. First let us write ZL is equal to, impedance is nothing but resistance plus reactance. So J into XL. So these ZL should be equal to the complex conjugate of Thevenin's impedance. Let us write Thevenin's impedance. VTH is equal to RTH plus J into XTH. So according to this statement, when the maximum power is transferred to this load, if this load impedance is equal to, if this load impedance is equal to complex conjugate of Thevenin's impedance. Complex conjugate of Thevenin's impedance. If ZTH is equal to RTH plus minus, that is a plus J into XTH, what will be the complex conjugate of ZTH? That is RTH minus J into XTH. What is ZL? RL plus J XL is equal to RTH minus J into XTH. So from this we can write RL is equal to RTH and XL is equal to minus XTH. So this is the first case. So in the first case we are going to consider this RL is variable, and XL is variable. RL is variable, this is a case 1. Case 1 is in ZL, in impedance, in load impedance, load resistance is variable and load reactance is variable. So in that case you have to adjust the load resistance in such a way that should be equal to Thevenin's resistance, and you have to adjust the load reactance in such a way that should be equal to minus of XTH. Like that you have to adjust RL and XL. Then only the maximum average power is delivered to the load. This is only the statement. Let us do the proof. Let us do the derivation. How RL becomes RTH and XL becomes minus XTH. Let us consider. So what we need to prove? We have to prove RL is equal to RTH and XL is equal to minus XTH. So let us consider a circuit. So this is a one network. This is one network and which is connected to some load, which is connected to some load, that is your ZL, and this load is variable. This load is variable. And let us consider, if I apply a Thevenin's theorem to this network, if I apply a Thevenin's theorem to this network, what happens? This network changes into here plus or minus VTH. Here you are going to get some ZTH and this is your ZL. What is this one? This is your VTH and this is your ZTH and this is your ZL. Nothing you have done, just we have applied to this network a Thevenin's theorem. Here we got VTH and a ZTH. VTH and ZTH. Let us consider the phasor of VTH becomes, the phasor value of VTH becomes VTH phasor, and if the current flowing is, let us consider I phasor is equal indicated with like this. This is your VTH phasor and ITH phasor. So from this we can write I phasor is equal to VTH phasor by I phasor is nothing, this is our ZTH and RL are connected in series. So ZTH plus ZL. ZTH plus ZL. I phasor is equal, that is our total current is equal to total voltage by total impedance. So from this we can write I phasor is equal to VTH phasor by what is the ZTH? ZTH is nothing but your RTH plus J into XTH. Let us write here. RTH plus J into XTH plus what is the ZL? ZL is equal to RL plus J into XL. Let us write here. RL plus J into XL. So this is your ZTH and this is your ZL. So from this we can write I phasor is equal to VTH phasor by, let us write real times RTH plus RL plus J into XTH plus XL. So this is your I phasor. Let us see power. Let us do the power calculations. So P average is equal to, while considering your complex power, while considering complex power, what is the complex power? Complex power is equal to S dash. S dash is equal to I square RMS. While discussing your complex power, we have considered this equation. S dash is equal to I square RMS into R plus J into I square RMS into X. So while discussing your complex power, we have considered this is your real power. This is your real power and this is your reactive power. This real power can be called as average power. Average power. So this is your imaginary. This reactive imaginary element. This is your real power, and this is also called as average power. So from this complex power concept, so here we can write average power is equal to P average is equal to. Why we are considering average power? According to the statement of your maximum power transfer theorem, the maximum average power is delivered to the load when the load impedance is equal to complex conjugate of your Thevenin's impedance. So that's why we are considering. Let us consider average power. So P average is equal to. So P average becomes I square RMS. I square RMS. So I square, that is your mod value. I square into RL. I square into RL. That is according to your, if I consider a resistor, I square into RL when I square into RL when VTH phasor and I phasor are RMS values. If VTH phasor and I phasor are RMS values corresponding to, if VTH phasor and I phasor values are corresponding to RMS values, then P average is equal to I square into RL. P average is equal to, if VTH and ITH are, if these two values corresponds to peak values, then what happens? That becomes your half of I square into RL. If VTH phasor and I phasor corresponds to maximum values, maximum value. How you will get half here? Let us see. IRMS is equal to Im by root 2. IRMS is equal to Im by root 2. If IRMS is equal to Im by root 2, then I square RMS is equal to Im by 2. That only we have considered. So if I is equal to RMS value, so I square RMS is equal to, if I consider in terms of maximum values, then here you will get your 2. This is a 2 which indicates your I square RMS. So P average is equal to I square into RL. So this is an average value equation. P average is equal to I square into RL. So let us see what is I from this equation. So we can write. Let us write here average power. So P is equal to, I square, that is of mod I square, that is of magnitude of your current, and into RL. But what is I? I is equal to VTH by RTH plus RL plus J into XTH plus XL. This is your I. So from this, what is a mod I? First of all, we have to consider mod I square into RL. What is a mod I? So mod I is equal to mod VTH, the magnitude of your VTH, by, what is the mod of this one? The mod of this one is under root of RTH plus RL whole square plus XTH plus XL whole square. What we need to find? Mod I square. So mod I square becomes, mod VTH whole square. And the denominator, square root gets cancelled. So here you will get RTH plus RL whole square plus xth plus xl whole square. So this is your p. So p is equal to mod vth whole square. Here you need to write rl. So if I substitute mod I square into rl, then p becomes that is your mod I square is vth mod vth whole square by rth plus rl whole square plus xth xl whole square into rl. This is your p. So in the mathematics, if I want to find the minimum value or maximum value, we use it to do the derivation. So let us consider p is equal to mod vth whole square into rl by rth plus rl whole square plus xth plus xl whole square. So I can write this p is equal to mod vth whole square into rl. I can consider this denominator to numerator. If I take this denominator to numerator, it becomes rth plus rl whole square plus xth plus xl whole square to the power of minus 1. So p is equal to mod vth whole square into rl. Here we have taken this denominator to numerator section, minus 1. So if I consider dp by, let us derivate this with dp by dxl. Dp by dxl and equate it to 0. If you do dp by dxl and equate it to 0, so let us take in a concept of d by dx of x power n. D by d of dx of x power n is equal to n into x power n minus 1. Similarly, if I consider d by dx of a into x power n, that is equal to a into n into x power n minus 1. But here we are doing with respect to xl. So if you observe here, do we have any xl term here? No. So this is considered the constant. Do we have an xl term here? No. Only we are having xl term here only. That is our xl term. We are doing the derivation with respect to your load reactance. So by doing the derivative, so what you are going to get? So dp by dxl is equal to mod vth whole square into rl, mod vth whole square into rl. So according to this one, minus n into minus n into x power n minus 1. So here you have to write rth plus rl whole square plus xth plus xl whole square n minus 1. What is n minus 1? Minus 1, that is your minus 2 into, the derivative of this one is 2 times of xth plus xl. 2 times of xth plus xl. So let us consider, let us take these 2 into denominator. So dp by dxl becomes vth mod vth whole square. Here you are having 2. So let us write here rl into minus 1 into 2, that is minus 2 into XTH plus XL by, let us take this to denominator. If I take it to denominator, RTH plus RL whole square plus XTH plus XL whole square, this is your whole square. So again, in the mathematics, if I want to find a maximum value or minimum value, what I used to do, we have to do the derivation and equate it to 0. So let us equate dp by dxl to 0. If I equate dp by dxl to 0, this denominator goes to multiplied with 0. So with this, what you are going to get? Vth whole square into RL into minus 2 times of XTH plus XL, which becomes equal to 0. This Vth is a constant value, that is your RL is a constant value, 2 is a constant, so it never be 0. Only this total term becomes 0, only there is a possibility of, for this one only, XTH and XL. So if XTH plus XL is equal to 0, then only this total term becomes 0. So if XTH plus XL is equal to 0, then only this total term becomes 0. So from this we can write XTH plus XL is equal to 0. XTH plus XL is equal to 0. If XTH plus XL is equal to 0, so from this what you can write? XL is equal to minus of XTH. XL is equal to minus of XTH. So according to this derivation, what we can conclude? XL is equal to minus of XTH. You have to adjust the load resistance in such a way that that should be equal to minus of XTH. Then only the maximum power is get transferred to the load. Similarly, we have to prove RL equal to RTH. Similarly, we have to prove RL equal to RTH. So what is the equation for I? I is equal to, that is your, so no need to consider I from starting. Let us consider P. What is the equation for P we got? P is equal to Vth whole square into RL by RTH plus RL whole square plus XTH plus XL whole square. If I substitute XL is equal to minus XTH, here, what happens? This total term becomes 0 if I substitute XL equal to minus XTH. Then what you are going to get? Vth mod Vth whole square into RL by RTH plus RL whole square. RTH plus RL whole square. So from this we can write P is equal to Vth whole square into RL by RTH plus RL whole square. So let us do, if I want to find RL equal to RTH, whether RL equal to RTH, do the derivation of this one. Let us do dp by drl, dp by drl and equal it to 0. If I do the dp by drl, I need to use, here you are having in the numerator, you are having RL, in the denominator you are having RL. So I need to take with the dp by dx of your u by v, something like u by v is equal to, so what is a u by v? So v into u dash minus u into v dash by v square. So v into u dash minus u into v dash by v square. So by this formula, so dp by drl is equal to, so dp by drl is equal to, so So what you are going to get? V square. The denominator V square. What is the V square? RTH plus RL whole square and its whole square. This is your V square. V square so V into U dash. What is V? V is equal to RTH. RTH plus RL. RTH RL whole square into U dash. What is the U dash? Mod VTH whole square. Minus what is U? VTH whole square into RL. And the V dash is 2 times of RTH plus RL. So if you equate this to 0, this denominator is multiplied with 0. So here you are going to get dp by drl is equal to. So dp by drl is equal to. So RTH plus RL whole square into mod VTH whole square, which becomes equal to mod VTH whole square into RL into 2 times of RTH plus RL. So from this we can cancel this one. So here you can write RTH plus RL is equal to RTH square plus RL square. How you got this one? Just you have multiplied with this 0 and you have taken this term to an RHS side. So 2 into RTH into RL is equal to 2 into RTH RL plus 2 into RL square. So this one gets cancelled. So from this we can write RL square, if I take this RL to RHS side, then RTH square is equal to 2 RL square minus RL square. So from this we can write RTH square is equal to RL square. This square gets cancelled. So from this we got RL is equal to RTH. So let us conclude. Here we got the help of maximum power transfer theorem. Here we got RL is equal to RTH and XL is equal to minus XTH. So from this we can conclude maximum power is delivered to the load if ZL is equal to RL plus J into XL, which must be equal to RL is equal to RTH minus J into XTH, which is nothing but your complex conjugate of your ZTH. So this is a case one where in ZL, RL plus J into XL, in this ZL, this RL is variable and XL is variable. So when RL is variable and XL is variable, if RL is variable and XL is variable, how we have to adjust this load resistance and load reactance? If RL is variable and if it is a variable, then only you can tune it. So you have to adjust or you have to vary this load resistance in such a way that this must be equal to RTH, and you have to tune this load reactance in such a way that should be equal to your XTH. Like that you have to tune this load resistance and your load reactance when RL is variable and XL is variable. How you are going to this RTH and XTH? By using your Thevenin's theorem. So by using the Thevenin's theorem, if they have given a problem and they have asked you to when the maximum power is delivered to the load and at which point we have to adjust the load resistance or load reactance. At that time, first of all, you have to apply Thevenin's theorem. And by applying Thevenin's theorem, you will get RTH and XTH. By using this RTH and XTH, you have to state, we need to tune the value of your RL in such a way that must be equal to your RTH, and you have to tune your XL in such a way that must be equal to your minus of XTH. So in the next class, we are going to see a case 2. In the next class, we are going to see, this is the case 1. So what is the case 1? So in the case 1, we have considered ZL is equal to, it is a combination of some load resistance plus load reactance, where this RL is variable and XL is variable. But in the case 2, we are going to see, where ZL is equal to RL plus J into XL, but only the RL is variable. If only the RL is variable, how we have to adjust this load reactance and load resistance? So there is no adjustment for this XL, because in the second case we are going to consider XL constant and RL variable. It means that we have to get an equation for RL only, because RL is variable. So for XL, that should be a constant. That is the case 2. In the case 3, where ZL is equal to RL, it means that if load impedance is equal to purely resistance, it means that in this case XL is equal to 0. In case 4, we are going to see ZL is equal to XL, RL is equal to 0. Then what happens? This is maximum power transfer theorem is very important. Because in our life we deal with every time with AC supply. We deal with sometimes with the DC, but more with AC supply only. So you need to know how the maximum power is delivered. This theorem is very helpful for your photovoltaic, for your solar panel. So in the solar panel also follows maximum power transfer, MPPT, that is your maximum power point. You have to calculate the maximum power point. There also we have to use this maximum power transfer theorem, because everywhere we expect maximum power only. So just do the same derivation in your notes, just practice it. Thank you.